Shalom. Before I begin this video, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai, Ba'ashem Rechakodash. Also as well, double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone that continue to rule very well to this very day, that is continually feeding the flock through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai. And also as well, shalom to the whole elect that's continually laboring his work and also labor to show forth your diligence to make your calling, election sure, in faith, in truth, sincerity, and also in all charity. All right, and the topic of this video is going to be entitled "When We Were a Great Far Off." Now, this is pursuant to the parable of the prodigal son, which is spoken of within the Gospels concerning our Lord Yahweh Shai, whom these people inwardly call Jesus, in which this parable speaking about the prodigal son being a great way off is regarding us, the nation of Israel, because that prodigal son represents the sons of the Heavenly Father, because pursuant to Exodus, it speaks about us being being his son. It says, "Israel is my son, even my firstborn." And see, now the son of the heavenly sons of the Heavenly Father, all right, the sons of the Most High, in which we are deemed as, are a great way off. In other words, we're here in captivity, far away from our resting place, which is the nation, the land of Israel. All right, we're far from home. So with that being said, you know, that parable concerning the prodigal son being a great way off, again, that represents us, because we went into captivity and were carried away into this land, and we were scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. And see, now we're returning to ourselves. We're returning to our heritage, and we're returning to our nationality of who we are. So when the scriptures say, when he came to himself, okay, that's talking about us returning back to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, by way of this word. Because like the scriptures say, when we were a great way off, you know, the Heavenly Father saw us. And that's happening now, because the Lord now is witnessing us fulfilling his will. Now we're fulfilling the words of which he has spoken of aforetime. And he sees that. And that's why the Lord now is returning to us, just how we are returning to him. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm to the precepts I have here. I'm not going to make this too long. I did a video beforehand, but it had an error, so I had to redo it. But this is the book of Luke, chapter 15, and this is at verse, let's see, Slakia. I'm going to get straight to the point. This is Luke chapter 15, and this is at verse 17. It says, "And when he had came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger." Okay, now again, this is the parable of the prodigal son. And this is when he left his home, his heritage, to go and live with a citizen of the country that he was in. And that citizen represents Esau, Edom, which is the true biblical nationality of the so-called white man. So again, it says here, when he came to himself, he said, "How many hired servants of my father's have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger?" Because he was, like the scriptures say, he was filling himself with the husk, or he would feign to have filled himself with the husk of the swine. But the son was making this statement here. It says, "How many of my hired servants, or how many of my father's hired servants, have bread enough in the spirit, and I perish with hunger?" And now, going to verse 18, it says, "I will arise and go to my father, and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee." Yeah, you see that? So now this is happening with the men of the Lord that you see today. The Israelites that have awoken to the gospel, and that gospel is that our Lord Yahweh Shai is coming back to come get us. He's coming back to deliver us out of this captivity. Okay. But continuing. It says, actually, I'm going to start from the top again at verse 18. It says, now I will arise and go to my father and will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. Okay, and that's what we are proclaiming, that we have sinned against the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shemuel Shai. That's us acknowledging our offense pursuant to the scripture. Okay. Well, scripture say, I will arise now and go into my place until they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. And now the Lord is pardoning us. So, and that's what's happening. It says, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. Okay, so those confessions are made. And now those confessions are being brought up to Yahweh by Hashem El Shai. So reading on verse 19, it says, and no more worthy to be called thy son, make me as one of thy highest servants. And he arose and came to his father, but when he was yet a great way off, here's the point, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And we always go into this, what's attached to your neck, your head, where your mind is. So the Lord saw us a great way off. That's us being here on in this part of the world, away from the face and the sight of Yahweh Baal Shem El Shai. And not just that, that also represents us spiritually, because the way that we were living before we came to ourselves, right? We were way off. And when I say way off, I mean we took onto ourselves the lives of Babylonians. Okay, the lives of the life of being a heathen. And we came back to ourselves, all right? And when you first, you know, realize who you are, that's when you start the journey. You know, that's when you start to learn more about your heritage. That's when you start to learn more about Yahweh Shem El Shai himself. So, but the thing is that the Lord sees that. And since he sees that, he's drawn himself near unto us. All right, the more days that pass, the more that our Lord Yahweh Baal Shem El Shai draws near, even more near each and every single day. So, reading on verse 19, it's like verse 20. Yeah, I said verse 21. It says, and the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet. You see that? So, and that pretty much wraps up this precept here. You know, and that pretty much hits the point of this precept, is that the Lord, Yahweh Baal Shem El Shai, saw us a great way off. And he met us on the way and had compassion on us. And the way that he had compassion on us is by allowing us to enter in back into his word, back into the doctrine and back into the truth. We gain access once again to the knowledge of Yahweh Baal Shem El Shai, because we didn't have it for a time. And that's why the scriptures say we came to ourselves. Okay. But I'm gonna move on from there. I got a few more precepts I want to grab. All right, this is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 11. And this is at verse 16. It says, therefore say, thus saith the Lord power, although I have cast them far off among the heathen, and although I have scattered them among the countries, yet will I be to them as a little sanctuary in the countries where they shall come. And the Lord is known as a little sanctuary amongst us. Because that's why you have these different camps that are set up in different parts of the world. And these are just little sanctuaries for the Lord Yahweh Baal Shem El Shai. Because when these camps were set up, They'll sit up through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem El Shai. And the Lord is in the midst of these camps. All right, the Lord's in the midst of the camps of Great Millstone right now. And you see that spiritually. So again, it says the Lord, Yahweh Bashem El Shai, is going to be a little sanctuary in the countries where we're going to come. And it doesn't stop here in Babylon the Great, which is America. Okay, you got camps in London. You got camps in, where else? Tanzania. Okay, you got camp over in the Philippines now. So the Lord is waking up Israel everywhere. All right, like I said, it doesn't stop here in Babylon because we were scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. So now we came to ourselves, I'm reiterating. We came back to ourselves, and now we have returned unto our Lord, Yahweh Bashem El Shai, and the Lord has met us on the way, like I said. And that's him allowing us to be able to understand his word once again. So going on from there, there's another precept I want to grab. This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 30. This is at verse 10. It says, "Therefore fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, saith the Lord, Yahweh Bashem El Shai, neither be dismayed, O Israel. For lo, I will save thee from far, and thy seed from the land of their captivity. And Jacob shall return, and shall be in rest, and be quiet. And none shall make him afraid." Okay? So it says, "Therefore fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, saith the Lord." Okay? Because the Lord, like it says here, is going to save us from far. And that's why it says salvation shall come from the east. So the Lord's going to save us from the land of our captivity. So in other words, he's going to gather us up from the four corners of the earth. And that's prophecy. Okay, there's prophecy that says that the Lord's going to send forth his angels throughout the four corners of the earth and gather his elect from the four winds. And then at that same time, the destruction is going to commence. So like the scripture saying in verse 10, it says the Lord is going to save us from far. So the salvation is going to come by way of those chariots. Okay, well, these people are inwardly called so-called UFOs. So I'll move on from there. I'm going to grab this last precept. This is the book of James, chapter 4. And that's NIV. Let me get the KJV. All right, James chapter 4. And this is at verse 7. It says, "Therefore submit to the Most High, Yahweh Bashem El Shai. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to the Most High, and he will draw near to you." See that? And that's the point. It says, "Draw near to the Most High, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded." Okay? It says, "Lament, mourn, and weep." It says, "Let your laughter be turned to mourning, and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he will lift you up." So the Lord is drawing near to us because we're drawing near to him, and we're cleansing our hands. Okay, we're cleansing our hands pursuant to Ezekiel, the 30th chapter, where it speaks about us blowing the trumpet and taking the blood off our hands by doing that. And that's what leads unto coming back to yourself as well. Now that you came to yourself and to your heritage, now there's a certain duty that comes with that. Because now you've been put in a position to also let your neighbor know, all right? Your neighbor represents your brother, okay? The brother that's out of the nation of Israel. Now you have to let your neighbor know who they are. And that's why Yahweh Shai was speaking about the law to fulfill, which is to love thy neighbor as thyself. So now you're understanding what that scripture means when it says love thy neighbor as thyself. This is what it is. You're warning your people about the coming danger, and you're introducing them back to their heritage. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and close out on that note. Like I said, I didn't want to make this video too long. I need to go ahead and take it in. But Lord's will is edifying to the elect of the nation of Israel. Until next time, once again, I want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh. Ba'ashim Yahushai, Ba'ashim Rukakodash. Also as well, double honors to the apostles. And that was a great millstone everywhere to this day. And also a shalom, peace of safety, and salutations to the hopeful elect, continuing to labor this work and labor to show forth your diligence to make your calling, election sure, in faith, in true sincerity, and all charity. And with that, go say shalom.